Hey everyone, this is Nick. Today I wanted to show you how you can use PowerPoint to make things like newsletter banners and website images, things that you might not associate with PowerPoint, but you can make them right inside of PowerPoint. Everything is custom and wonderful. So a lot of people work with different sort of management mailing systems like MailChimp or something like that, and you might think that you need an image for a banner or you need an image for some other placeholder in your newsletter, and that just must mean that you need a photo. So you take that photo, you put it into MailChimp, and all of a sudden it gets really huge and you have to figure out how you can resize the photo to make it perfect. Well, I think that you can do it right inside of PowerPoint, export the slide as an image, and then put it perfectly right into your newsletter. So I have kind of this mock-up right here for the Cougar Foundation weekly newsletter. We have a beautiful photo in the background. You can see that the slide is actually a custom dimension. It's set to 1 inch by 8 inches across. You could set your slide to anything that you want to do, and I have some text right here and an image right here. We could do even more with the design of this, but I'm going to show you how to do this really quickly. So let's go ahead and open a new PowerPoint presentation. This is what you'll get, the standard slide right there. I'm going to go ahead up to the slide layouts and just choose the blank layout so that we're starting with a blank layout here. Now the first thing we need to do is customize the size to the banner size. So I'm going to click on the design tab, go over to slide size, click on custom size, and if you go to this drop-down menu, it gives you a bunch of stock options. You could go down to the banner, which gives you a 1x8, but maybe I want a little bit of a larger banner, so I'm just gonna click on custom, and I want mine to be 8 inches wide and 2 inches high. Make sure that the landscape and landscape orientations are selected because that's gonna be the wide format. We'll click on okay, say maximize for size, and now you see we have a new slide size right here. Now let's go ahead and insert that image. I'm gonna go ahead and insert the image from stock images. Let's go ahead and let's say that we're gonna do image of a parakeet. Let's do the parakeet foundation right here. Let's see if this one will look pretty good here. I'm gonna click on this one, and it's gonna insert the picture as large as it could possibly be, but you can see it's not going to fill the entire length of the slide, so we need to fill the entire length of the slide. One thing you could do is you could zoom back, click down here on your lower left here on the zoom features, go all the way out, zoom all the way out, and I'm going to go ahead and move the picture over to the left-hand side. We're going to go ahead, hold down the shift key, and then the bottom corner of the photo, that's going, once you drag this out, that's going to resize everything proportionally so you don't stretch it wide or too tall or too wide. So make sure to hold down the shift key and stretch it all the way across the slide. Now, you can see over here on the left-hand side, that gives you a little preview of what that slide's gonna look like. Right now, the little parakeet is only looking above the bottom of the slide. Now, that could actually be a pretty cute little effect here, but what if I want that parakeet to be in the middle? All I need to do here is just hit the up arrow and just nudge it into place. That's one way you could do it. And you can see that's gonna be a lot of nudging. And that might look pretty good like that. I kind of like that. Now the thing is, if you were to put this into slideshow mode, let's go ahead down here, put this into slideshow mode, it still gives you the size. All of that extra stuff on the top of the photo is not seen. So you don't see the extra part of the photo on the top or the bottom. You only see the part of the slide that you need. I'm gonna push escape to get out of this. And if I were to save this as an image file, that would also just show me exactly what's on that slide. So let's go ahead and save this as a PNG. I'm gonna click on Save As, Browse. Let's just go over to my desktop and we will save this as Parakeet. When you do this, you can see that it's gonna save the file type as a PowerPoint presentation. We don't want that, we want an image file. So scroll down to the PNG or the JPEG. I'm gonna go ahead and say JPEG and then we'll click on Save. And it's gonna say all slides in this deck or just one. Now, I just want it to save this one slide, so I'm gonna say just this one. And now we're gonna have an image. Let's go ahead and find it. It's probably over here on my other screen. Let's drag this over. Here's my little parakeet image right here. And now this is a perfect image file that you can just import into MailChimp. Let's drag it over here. So there's my little image. It's perfect. This is so awesome. I love that. And inside of Windows or Microsoft now, you can probably do some editing in this if you want to too. But you know what? I just like to go over to PowerPoint and use PowerPoint for all of my editing. Now, if I wanted to crop this photo down, I could do that just by going to the Picture Format tab, make sure that the photo is selected. Over here on the Crop menu, push crop, and you can go ahead and drag the crop crop tools so that the size of the slide is right there, and just click on crop, and now it has cropped that photo. Super, super cool. Now, here is the bonus trick. For the bonus trick, let's go ahead and do another one. I'm gonna insert a new blank slide. The bonus trick, you have to go over to brightcarbon.com and download the free PowerPoint add-in called BrightSlide. You can see if you've downloaded it, you will have BrightSlide right here. I have a lot of videos on BrightSlide. I'm gonna link those above and below. There's a lot of little things you can do in BrightSlide that will help you edit photos and also export slides as images. So right now, we're gonna go ahead and insert a new photo. Let's go ahead and click on stock images. And let's say this time I would like a photo of a forest. So I'm gonna type that in. Let's see, which forest do I want? Let's just do this slide here of like bamboo. That looks kind of cool. So that's gonna fill the part of my slide that the photo would normally fill, but again, we want the whole slide to be filled. BrightSlide has a feature that in the click of the button will proportionately size a photo to the size of your slide. So click the photo, click on the BrightSlide menu right here, go to match to size, and just click match to size. And that's going to make that photo expand to the entire size of the slide, and it's going to do so proportionally. So all of that extra stuff on top and on bottom are cut off of the photo. Now, if I wanted to crop it, you can still crop it. So go to the picture format menu, hit crop, and then you can go ahead and drag this around. Now, here's another little trick. Kind of dragging around sometimes gets a little wonky because you can go left, right, sideways. If you hold down the shift key, it will only allow you to drag the photo up and down or left and right across a horizontal or vertical plane. You won't be able to do anything diagonally. So I like to do that, and so that gives me a nice little way that to kind of drag or resize photos just like this. Now, BrightSlide can also allow you to export slides as images, but you have to first save the file. So actually, I'm gonna go ahead and save this file. We'll just save it as presentation 2 for now. I'm just gonna go ahead and put it into documents right here. Now, if you wanted to export this slide or all of the slides as images in one swoop, all you have to do is go to the BrightSlide tab and click on the export menu right over here under File and Master, click on Export, and you can say Save Selected Slides as Images. Now, the cool part about this is that it allows you to save images as larger than they actually are, so that you will have even more clarity if you need a large image. So right now, you can see the scale. I've already set mine to 4 times larger than the actual photo. You can go down, you could set it to, you know, you could just set it to 2 times bigger. If we wanted to, we would click OK, and then it's gonna ask us where we wanna put these slides. I'm gonna select the folder, and now it says slide 1 exported as the JPEG right there, that image right there. Looks pretty, pretty cool. Let's go see if it has saved on our menu here, right? This is probably that photo right there. It could be the parakeet. Oh, no, it's the bamboo. Super cool. So you can save those images like that with BrightSlide, which is a pretty cool trick. So I love that. So there's a couple ways here that you can create really custom website images and newsletter images directly inside of PowerPoint. You don't need any other software. You don't need editing software. You don't need Canva to do this. If I wanted to add text or other design elements to these slides, all I have to do is add those things just like I normally would in PowerPoint, export these as an image, and you have the image right there with all the text and design elements that you want. So I hope you use this. Let me know how you do in the comments. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.